and Sesame Street Show 2002, produced in color in New York at Reeves.
Welcome to Sesame Street. Hey, Luis, just the guy I want to see.
Yeah, what's happening, Big Bird?
Hey, how'd you like to go roller skating?
Roller skating?
Yeah, we could have a lot of fun.
I don't know if I can go roller skating with a broken arm, Big Bird.
You don't use your arm to roller skate, Luis. Look, you use your feet. See, and you've got your feet, your legs, and you just go around and around.
I know that, you see, but I'm not very good at it to begin with, you know, and I need both my arms to balance.
To balance?
Yeah.
Let me see. Yeah, I use my wing to keep balance.
Hey, see?
I guess you'd need your arms, too, not just your feet. Gosh, I wanted us to do something together, Luis.
Well, I'm afraid I won't be able to do very much right now, Big Bird, because Susan's driving me to the hospital in about 5 minutes.
The hospital?
Yeah.
But I thought you were getting better. Why do you have to go to the hospital?
Oh, it's nothing. Don't worry about it. The doctor just wants to give me a checkup to see if my arm is getting better.
Hi, Luis. I'm ready to go.
Oh, hey, Luis. Can I go, too?
Well, I don't know, Big Bird.
I just want to make sure you're okay.
I'm going to be all right. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, but you just said that the doctor's going to see if you are okay. Can I go, please? Please, 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 please,
Well, it's
please.
All right with me. Susan, what do you think? You know more about these things than I do.
It'll be fine, because I'll be there, too. Listen, but Big Bird, you're going to have to sit in the same place for a long, long time, and there won't be much to do.
Oh, well, that doesn't bother me, Susan.
Okay.
Does it mean I can go?
Yes, you can go.
Yeah? Sure. Okay, I'll just go take off my roller skates.
Okay, hurry.
All right, I'm hurrying.
Big Bird, are you all right?
Okay.
I'm fine. I just learned something else about roller skating.
What's
Besides
that?
Needing your arms and legs, you need to... Watch where you're going.
All right, Marvin. Let's see how smart you are.
Okay, Ralph.
Now, what would happen if you didn't have a mouth?
I couldn't talk.
Right. And what if you didn't have a nose?
I couldn't smell.
Right again. Now, Marvin, what would happen if you didn't have any ears?
I couldn't see.
Exactly. What do you mean you couldn't see if you didn't have any ears?
My hat would fall down over my eyes.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Couldn't hear either, for that matter. Hey, where are you going?
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog, here to show you what's inside of Harry Monster. Now, Harry, if you'll just sort of take your place up there, we can get started.
I can't wait to find out what I'm like.
Okay, well, just turn on the machine here. And there.
Boy, I'm crowded.
Yeah, now as you can see, there's a lot of stuff inside of Harry Monster. I see right here, keeping things protected, are Harry's ribs.
You see? Oh, that tickles.
Mm-hmm.
Only joking.
Yeah, well, you see now, they kind of sort of rise and fall every time Harry breathes. Now, if Harry were to take a deep breath, Harry, why don't you take a deep breath?
Okay.
Very good, Harry. Now, as you can see, every time Harry breathes in, he fills his lungs up here with air, and he breathes out, then his lungs empty. Now, there's even more stuff underneath all this stuff here. So let me just I'll dial out Harry's and bring in. There we go. Now here is Harry's heart beating away kerchunk kerchunk.
Doesn't look like a heart.
Well, actually, it's sort of a big muscle working to pump blood all around Harry's body. And looking even deeper in Harry's body, there we've got the pipe that goes from Harry's mouth to his tummy.
Hmm.
Now, Harry, why don't you say ah?
Ah.
Now, eat a cracker, Harry. Now, if Harry eats a cracker, you'll see little bits of cracker that will go down the pipe down into Harry's tummy where they all get kind of mushed up, you see? And, of course, there's other stuff. There's other stuff in there. There are things like a, there's a liver and, yeah, there's a liver there and there's some intestines here and all kinds of other bits and pieces and odds and ends and stuff like that. So now you know what's inside of Harry Monster.
Well, what about my muscles?
Well, Harry, if we showed your muscles, we wouldn't be able to see the rest of your insides because they sort of cover everything else up, you know?
But my muscles are my best part.
Okay. Well, let's see. Running back through that, we come to Harry's muscles.
Whoa. Look at that definition.
Yep. So now you've seen what's inside of Harry, and what's inside of Harry is almost the same as what's inside of a kid like you or a frog like me.
Oh, I gotta see what this looks like close up.
Wait a minute. Harry, how'd you do that?
Whoa, look at those pecs.
But wait a second.
Wow.
Something's wrong.
Poetry in motion.
I'll check the back here. Hey, what? Oh, Harry, why are you doing this?
Kangaroo. A kangaroo from Timbuktu went to the park for a barbecue. He put on his bib, chewed on a rib, then hopped off to Kalamazoo. Kangaroo.
That's a funny walk. A flock of flamingos. What's a flamingo? There must be thousands of them. They eat with their heads upside down. They drink with their heads upside down, too. Wow, look at him fly. There's three of them flying. Flamingos.
A demonstration by the Pink Panther. Clever, the letter K for the word karate.
Teeny little super guy. One Tuesday, my little friend R.W. Shipshape came up to me with a problem. There was a melancholy air about him with a touch of the old ennui as he approached me. In other words, he looked pretty sad. What's the trouble, R.W.? I asked him.
I want a pet.
Pets are nice, I said. What's wrong? Won't your mom and dad let you have one?
They said I could have one, but that pets are a big responsibility. They said I should think it over.
So, are you thinking it over?
No.
Why not?
Because,
he said,
I don't know what they mean by responsibility.
I see, I said when I saw. It's hard to think about something when you don't know what you're thinking about. Responsibility for a pet means you have to take care of the pet.
Why?
R.W. said. Because pets can't take care of themselves very well. What kind of pet are you thinking about?
I kind of want a pet spoon,
R.W. said. Pet spoons are nice, but think about this. You'll have to feed him.
What do they eat?
Canned spoon food or spoon kibble, generally. You've also got to take them for walks, always remembering to keep them on a leash. And you've got to clean up after them.
Sounds okay so far.
You've got to play with them and show them love and affection.
Boy, I see what you mean. Responsibility for a pet spoon takes a lot of time.
That's right. And that's what your mom and dad wanted you to think about before you get a pet.
I understand,
R.W. said. So, what do you think, R.W.? Are you going to get a pet spoon?
Either that or a pet can opener,
R.W. said and went home. Just remember, you guys, if you're going to get any kind of pet, you'll have to take care of it and be responsible. Huh? Get on, big fella. Huh? Get on, boy. Ah, you're a good spoon. Here, let me scratch it behind the ear. Oops. Oh, don't. You're mixing me up. Don't. You're mixing me all up. Oh, cut it out, fella. Oh, cut it out.
I'm just a teeny little super guy.
Oh, yeah.
So this is a hospital emergency room.
No, Big Bird, this is a hallway.
Yeah. I have to check in first to let him know I'm here. Come on, this way.
Watch your head, Big Bird. Dr. Stone, emergency.
Well, just have a seat and the doctor will be with you in just a minute, okay?
Buenos días.
Oh, buenos días. ¿Y el brazo cómo anda?
Bueno, mucho mejor. No me duele ya.
Ay, qué suerte.
Pero,
look, Susan, look at this sign here.
Mm-hmm. Se habla español.
Se habla español.
Mm-hmm. It means Spanish spoken here.
Uh-huh. Se habla español. Right here?
Right here.
No lo tiene que tener tanto tiempo.
Creo menos tiempo. Sí, ¿verdad? Tres semanas.
Tres semanas, algo así.
They're speaking Spanish. Wow, that is one smart sign.
Look, the way I figure, if we all work together and cooperate, we may be able to bust out of this zoo. My teeth can saw through these bars. If one of you can hold me up and use me like a saw.
I could hold you up and saw.
Good. Now, once the bars are cut, we'll have a 6-foot drop down to the street below.
I can crawl down the wall.
And I can jump that far.
Yes, but I can't do either of those things. Do we have a rope?
No, but we have a snake.
Yeah, I could hang out the window and you could climb down me.
Great. Now, we have the money we'll need, but how can we carry it while we're climbing out the window?
There's no way I can carry it.
Well, I won't hold it in my mouth. That's dangerous.
Look, I have a pocket.
Great! Okay, it's all set. The truck will come by for us in 1 hour, right?
Right!
Right!
There's the truck! Let's go! What did I tell you? We all worked together and we made it. We're out.
And here's the truck.
And I have the money.
All right, boys. What'll it be tonight?
Ice cream.
Ice cream.
Are we ready to blast off?
Almost. Tell you what. Get a wrench.
Oh, please, Doctor. Hurry.
Okay. Ready. Oh, it's a beauty. We're ready.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
Greetings. For days and days now, my able assistant, Dr. Rainbrain...
Yeah, that's me, Rainbrain, that's me.
Yes, and I have been perfecting the Transylvanian rocket ship.
Yeah, okay, we're ready.
And we're ready now to blast off, so, for the countdown.
Okay, ready for countdown, ready.
10 terrific seconds. 9 nifty seconds.
Yeah.
8 exciting seconds.
Yeah.
7 scintillating seconds.
Yeah.
6 super seconds.
Hurry.
Hurry, yes. 5 fabulous
hurry,
seconds.
Hurry.
4 fantastic
faster,
seconds.
Faster.
3 terrific seconds.
Yeah, hurry.
2 tremendous
faster.
Seconds. 1
faster.
1 wonderful second.
All right.
Blast off. Yes, a wonderful success.
But it stayed right here. It stayed here.
Of course it stayed here. That's the beautiful thing about it. Now I get to do the countdown again. Only this time in Transylvanish. Trigaxki. Dukablik. Singolia. Blastoweski.
There are a lot of circles. What's that?
It's the sun.
Inside the sun is a circle.
Two circles.
The wheels of the bicycle are two circles.
Now there's a bunny eating flowers, and inside the flowers there are circles.
Bobby can eat the circles.
There are two circles.
There's a girl eating cookies.
The cookies are round shape. Now it's a girl in a circle.
Bicycle.
Trees are places where birds can have a home, build a nest, or find a branch of their own. A tree can be a place where children have a playhouse, or a real home for animals. Trees for hiding, or hide and seek. Trees for just taking a peek. Trees can be cool and shady, or just a place to dream. Some trees have fruit, like oranges, and apples, and pears. And lots of leaves, green and delicious. Trees take you far from the ground, where you can see all around. trees can even hold you. Trees are very nice places.
Gotta brush my pearly whites so they don't lose their bite. When I swim downstream, I make those other fishes scream. They'll jump with the light, with the light. At the sight of my white, bright, clean, all and clean, I mean, perfectly pearl white teeth. They're the key to my success. I'm the king of toothsomeness. All the little fish beside me tried to hide, but when they spot me, they were stunned. Oh, happiness, they were stunned by the sight of my white, bright, longer than long, strong, perfectly pearl white teeth. Side of my white bride, longer than long, strong, perfectly pearl white teeth. Couldn't you just eat me up?
What in the blue carnation was that?
I don't know.
The split up.
Oh, is that safe?
Yes. Okay. I'm next to you, yes. And you're next to me.
Yeah.
Let's change that.
All right.
You go over next to the cactus.
Next to the cactus?
Yes.
Yeah. What are you going
to
do?
I'm going to go next to the rock.
I don't know what next to means,
you
but
just
I trust
you. Slither on over there. Get right beside of that's next to. Go on, go on, go on.
Fine, fine, no good cowpoke.
Whoa, you got right on top of the cactus. I told you to get next to
the
cactus.
I told you I didn't know what next to means.
It means right beside of.
Oh.
What made that sound?
There's some other guys.
Well, now you're next to them other guys.
Oh, there's my little friend Jan. I gotta go say hi.
Okay.
Hi, Jan. Remember me?
Oh, hi, Luis.
Yeah, how are you?
Good.
Oh, this is my friend Big Bird. Big
Hello.
Bird, this is Jan.
Oh, hello, Jan. Gee, look at that. You got a cast on your arm, just like Luis.
That's how we met. We were both waiting here holding our broken arms.
Mm-hmm. Did you have to do everything Luis did, like get x-rays and everything?
Yes, everybody who breaks something has to do all that.
Yeah, we were the first ones to sign our casts. Look, see? She wrote Jan on there.
Oh, yeah, and you signed on?
Yeah,
let me see.
Yours.
Oh, look at that. There's your name. Luis. Oh, says other things. Hi, Jan, your friend Sarah. Oh, look at this one a lot. Says, to Jan, we'll play jacks when your arm is well. Your best friend, Lisa. I have a best friend. Oh, and look, there's room that I could sign it right here. Want me to sign it for you?
Sure, go ahead.
Okay, you got a pen, Luis?
No.
Jan, it's your turn to see the doctor.
We'll see you later, Jan.
Yeah, but I didn't get a chance to sign her cast. Jan, I'll sign it later, okay?
Bye-bye.
Oh, boy. What a neat place. Look at all this nice stuff. Such a... Oh, gee, lady. What's wrong with you? Why, you don't even look sick.
You know, only Big Bird could enjoy himself in a hospital waiting room.
You said it.
What if we celebrated Valentine's Day with chickens instead of hearts? Then we would say, I love you with all my chicken.
My name is Robert, and I'm in third grade. I like baseball and basketball, and I also like to dance. Every week, the school bus comes and takes us to the Alvinelli School every week. We learn lots of steps and new things and dancing and stuff.
First of all, I don't have very much time today to be explaining to you.
This is my teacher, Mr. Figueroa.
Now, I want to see how much you know. Where is the pelvis? Show me where the pelvis is. Yes. What are the abdominals? What are the abdominals? Who knows?
We learn about all the bones and muscles that we use when we dance.
What about the muscles in the lower back? What are the muscles there? What are they called? Say it. Psoas. Everybody say psoas.
Psoas.
Everybody sitting down, please. Soles of the feet together. Now remember, lift up. Make sure your back is flat. And oh, one, two, and smile, and roll, one, two, and down, four counts, point, and up, one, and down, lift up over the top of the head, flex, roll down, point, knee straight, arms in second, and up, 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 and stand up, five, six, hands down, roll down, one, two, three, bounce on a one, keep your head center, and round up, two, three, second, and round, two, three, bounce on a one.
We do exercise to strengthen our stomach muscles and our backs and our legs. And we roll our heads. We do all of that to get in shape. So if you're moving your neck or something, you won't crack it and get it stuck or nothing.
Seven and ha! Okay, we're gonna do it again because I didn't like it. It didn't sound correct. Ready?
We can't be lazy. He Ready? Starts it over.
Five, six, seven, and ha! Two. Ha, ha! Ha, ha! Ha! Good, better. Five, six, seven,
eight. Everybody has to move together in a dance.
Turn one. Don't push back. Don't let go, don't let go. And over here. Okay. Okay, now we'll gather around the drummer to thank him for his music, please. Five, six, seven, and ha, ha, ha!
When I grow up, I want to be a policeman.
A nice looking sign. Limk. Oh no, another one of those mixed up things. I'll just change those letters around, that's all. Okay, there. Mikl. Mikl. Oh, did it wrong again. I'll just put this over here and this over there. Okay. Milk. Milk. Oh, that's easy. Milk!
Anyone for milk? You want milk? I got milk. Here you go.
Milk.
get well soon. Paul. Boy, you have lots of stuff on yours, Paul. Wow. I bet you're almost glad you broke your leg.
Louise, look!
Oh,
good for you, Jim.
It's healed. Congratulations. How does it feel, huh?
Good. Looks funny. And feels funny.
Yeah?
Looks funny, too.
Well, that's normal, so you have to practice using it again, okay?
I guess so.
Gee, it's not broken anymore?
No.
Wow. Louise, you're going to get your cast off, too?
I'm afraid not, Big Bird. We grown-ups take a lot longer to heal than children do.
Oh, too bad. Mm. Well, Jan, I guess I'm not going to get to sign your cast after all, huh?
Sign it anyway. I'm saving it.
Okay. Have you got a pen?
Oh, yes, I have one, Big Bird. Here you go.
Oh, thank you. Oh, boy. You know, I like writing on cast, especially after they come off.
What's he excited about? Oh, about his car. It's short. Hey, what's going on here? No, it's long. Short. Long. Short. Long. And away they go. But not far. I think the car is going to be short again. Very...
Watch out!
Short.
Long suspenders. Longer. Longest.
Excuse me, sir. Do you happen to know what B-U-S spells? It spells bus. Do you know what a bus is? Very good. Now, you know how to draw a straight line, don't you? Excellent. Now, could you draw a line under the word bus if... Now stop that. I said under the word bus. Now, if you'd step over here. Remember, B-U-S, bus. Did you find it? No? Are you sure? No. Okay, you did it.
Hey, Melissa, me and Sisha are going to have a bike parade. Ask your mom if you can come. And it's Saturday by the river. And bring a bike or a scooter because we get to decorate them.
I need a big pen.
Come on, yellow.
know, some things that are really easy for you are real hard for me.
Yeah, but some things are easy for you that are hard for me.
Five.
You want a five?
Terrific, man. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, come on, that's right. Let's turn it around. Yeah, that's it. That's right.
Pretty good, huh?
Time. Now you try it.
La 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 la.
Hello, dear. This is Professor Grover, and today I am going to tell you all you ever wanted to know about taking a bath. And I know everything about taking a bath because, well, I take one every single day. Yeah, it is very important to take baths because, well, that is how you keep your fur bright blue and squeaky clean. Now, there are two things, count them, two things you need when you take a bath. First of all, a bathtub, which I have plenty of surrounding me right here. See, this is a bathtub right here. And the second thing you need is some of this cleaning stuff here, which is called? Oh, yeah, soap. This is a bar of soap. Those two things are what you need to take a bath, okay? Now, all you have to do is rub this soap all over your body like this. Maybe you start with your neck right here. Just rubber, 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 rubber. See, that's one place you can clean. Maybe your tummy next. Rubber, 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 rubber. Maybe your nose you could clean too. Like that. Just rub your nose with a soap. Yeah. Maybe your cheek. Yeah, you could clean your cheek in the tub. Right there. Isn't that nice? You could clean your arm here, see? Right here. Right by the elbow there. My arm gets a little dirty there. Right there. And even your shoulder right here. It's hard to find my shoulders because they're a little weak. I am not that strong, but I am wiry. And entree.
Oh, good, Grover, dear.
Oh, Mommy. Hi, Mommy.
I see that you are ready for your bath, dear.
Well, no, Mommy. I'm not ready for my bath. I am taking a bath, Mommy. Yeah, see? I have my bathtub and my soap. The two necessities of bathing.
But, Grover, dear, you cannot take a bath with your hat on. It will get wet.
Wet? How will it get wet, Mommy?
Well, dear, it will get wet from the water. You see here?
Water?
There, yes, dear.
Water. As I was saying, there are three things you must have in order to take a bath. Oh, I am so embarrassed.
Wait.
Big Bird, we told you there would be a lot of waiting.
Senor Rodriguez, please. Time for you to come in.
It's your turn.
Oh.
Come on, we're gonna go in.
Oh, no. I'm sorry, you can't come.
But I'm his friend.
I know, but those are the rules.
Oh,
it's all right, Big Bird. I'll see you later.
Yeah. Gee whiz, you wait and you wait and you wait, and then they don't let you go in, and then you have to wait some more.
Big Bird, I know we waited a long time, but don't you think it makes Luis feel better to know we're here with him and we're waiting for him?
Yeah. What do you think's happening to him?
Well, first they're going to take an X-ray of his arm.
Well, why would they do that? They already did that.
Well, so the doctor can see if the broken bone is healing properly.
Oh, then what happens after the X-ray?
Well, he'll go to see the doctor, who will ask Luis to wiggle his fingers.
Wiggle his fingers?
Yeah, and then the doctor will also check to see if he still has feeling in all of his fingers by touching his fingers.
Oh. All that sounds like fun, but why would a doctor want Luis to do all that silly stuff?
Oh, Big Bird, that's to find out if he can do all that, then that means his cast is not too tight.
Hmm. Big Bird, Susan.
Yeah?
The doctor says it's okay to come in and see the X-rays.
Oh, far out. Oh, boy.
Watch your head, Big Bird.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, I'm going to see the X-rays.
It's got to be quiet in the hospital.
Oh, okay.
Watch your head, Big Bird.
Oh, here he is. Come over here, this way.
Come here.
Doctor, these are my friends I was telling you about. This is Big Bird.
That's me.
And this is Susan.
Hello.
Susan. This is Dr. Foster.
Hello, Doctor.
Hello, Dr. Foster.
Hello. Nice to meet you. I was just looking at Luis's X-rays here, and his arm's healing very nicely.
How can you tell?
Well, you see this X-ray? Mm. This was taken when Luis first broke his arm.
Is that the broken place?
Yeah, you see that line?
Wow.
Yeah. Mm. That's the break.
Well, how is it now? But this one looks a lot better. Is this a new one?
Yeah, this X-ray was taken this morning. As you can see,
it's healing very nicely. Yeah, you can hardly see the place where it was broken, huh?
That's good to hear that it's healing, let me tell you, Doc.
Great.
Right. It's coming along just the way it should.
Does this mean that you can go roller skating with me?
I don't think it's a good idea for Luis to go roller skating right now. But, you know, you should do something active.
Yeah.
Because you need to get your exercise.
Of course, sure, yeah. Okay, well, thanks a lot, Doctor. Right. And don't worry, Big Bird, we'll find something fun to do, okay?
Oh, good.
All right.
Goodbye, doctor.
Thanks, doctor.
Thanks a lot.
Gee.
Gee, I'm glad you're getting along so good. Excuse me.
Whoa, low ceiling. Hey, you know, coming to the hospital was a really neat experience for me. I like this. We could stay a while, you know, or maybe come back tomorrow.
No, Big Bird, we have to go home.
But I'm not doing any of this afternoon. Yeah. And you can come back and have your arm checked again.
No, let's go home now.
But wait.
Breath. You can move your feet to walk, and you use your tongue to talk, but your mouth and nose are waiting. Take a breath. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. You can move your teeth to chew, but your face is turning blue. Get some air inside of you, just take a breath. You never think of breathing, though you do it all day long. You even have to breathe to sing this funny little song. You've got to take a breath before you try to blow a bubble. And if you stop your breathing, you got big, big trouble. So take a good deep breath. That's better. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. There are many ways to play, but you're growing every day, and you need some ventilation. Take a breath. You got to do your breathing. Take a breath. Take a breath.
Presenting the pencil.
Oh, my favorite animal? Oh, I don't know. I like dogs. Mm-hmm. And elephants? Do you like elephants, Grover? Just a second.
La,
hey, Bert just came home. There's something I want to talk to Bert about. I'll call you later, Grover. Okay, bye-bye.
Hi, hello, Ernie!
Hi, Bert. Hi, Bert. Hey, what do you have in the box there?
Well, why don't you read it and see what the word says?
Let's see. It says telephone. It says telephone.
Uh-huh.
Is that
telephone.
The word telephone, Bert?
Telephone, right,
telephone.
Ernie.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Well, what's in the box, Bert? I mean, it can't be a telephone because we already have a telephone.
Ernie,
what's in there?
Why don't you open up the telephone box and see what's inside?
Okay, let's see.
La, la, la. La, 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 la. Ernie, don't throw that on the floor.
I'm sorry, Bert. I'll pick it up later. I couldn't wait to see what's...
Uh-huh.
Hey, Bert.
Uh-huh.
Look at this.
Uh-huh.
Why, it's a telephone, Bert.
That's right.
It's one of those neat old-fashioned telephones.
Yep. Yep, yep.
Well, what's this telephone for, Bert?
Well, see, Ernie, here, let me just plug it in there.
Okay.
There.
Hmm?
Yeah, see, it has a whole separate line and everything. I can call out, uh-huh.
Well, that's wonderful.
And do you know why?
Bert.
Do you know why?
No, why did we get that? Because we already have one telephone, Bert.
We have a telephone, Ernie. Mm-hmm. We do. That is our telephone there, right?
Right.
But you always use it. I can never use our telephone. You're always on it.
Oh, dear, Bert.
I have decided to get my own telephone, and now I can call on my own phone and receive calls on my own phone.
That's wonderful, Bert.
Right, without having to wait for you.
Great.
And now I'm expecting a call from Cleveland, from a dollar cap collector. Yes.
Oh, that's lovely, Bert.
Hello?
Hello, Bert? Hey, Bert, this is Ernie. Listen, I was just calling you because I'm really happy that you got your own telephone, Bert. Yeah, now I can call you all the time. Yeah, and we can talk this way. Bert? Are you there, Bert?
Hey, look, it's the letter J.
So letter J goes J. Here he comes. What's that? Oin, oin. Oin. Join. There they go. Join. Look at that big ump. Ump! It's blocking the track. Ump. I know. Jump. Jet. Now he's junk.
Hello there, and welcome to Monsterpiece Theater. Me, Alistair Cookie. Today, we're going to see the thrilling and stirring story of two friends who race down a beach, each helping the other to be the best that he can be. As story begins, the race is about to start. So now, let's watch Chariots of Fur.
Okay, Grover, old bean. We're going to run to the end of the beach.
Oh, well, I do not think I want to do that, hairy old chap.
Well, of course you do, Grover, old bean. Because when we get there, you're going to get something wonderful.
Really, hairy old chap? What is that?
Oh, you'll have to wait till we get there before you find out, Grover, old bean. But anyway, running is good exercise, and it's fun, and it's good for you.
Well, then let us begin, hairy old chap. Get ready, old chap. Get set, old chap. Go! Old chap.
Save your breath.
Chariots
have done it without you, Harry, old chap.
My pleasure, Grover, old bean.
Oh, now, what am I going to get now that I've made it to the end of the beach, Harry, old chap?
Grover, old bean, you get...
Yes, 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 yes!
...to run the other way.
And so end our story of friendship between an old chap and an old bean. Thank you for watching this Alistair Cookie for Monsterpiece Theater.
Now watch this. I'm going to try it with my left hand. See if I can do it.
Ah, yes. Oh, close, close.
Here we go. Ready? Oh.
Wow.
Well, I just have to keep trying. You want to try one?
Oh yeah, let me All try. Right. See if I can do it one-handed like
your
you.
Left winged hook there. Ready?
Here it goes. Gonna try.
Ready? Oh,
all right. I'm not very good at this.
Okay, let's see if I can do it here.
Oh. Close.
Let's do it. I made it.
You did it. You win. You win.
Try it again.
Okay. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters J and K and by the number 5. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.